When I say, that's serious issues, need serious people, this is what I always mean. But, as you have clicked on the video, you are eager to know what is really happening, what this time round, President Ibrahim Traore is planning to do with Russia. When your eyes look at things concerning energy, most especially nuclear, a good number of you know what it means, because you know the seriousness of nuclear energy in terms of war, among a number of uses, as we are going to find out why. The captain needs nuclear power in his country. Before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and also thank the channel through any funds you may wish by clicking on the thanks button on your app, because the channel needs finances to grow, a great thing, African channels need to grow. Now, back to the topic. Ever since, Russia became an ally with Burkina Faso, under President Ibrahim Traore, we are seeing a number of changes in this West African country. From expelling the West, most especially France, to signing a number of agreements with Russia, Burkina Faso, under the captain, is continuing to show jaw-dropping changes and things which are scaring off the West. Again, let's think about nuclear energy. What comes to your mind when you hear about nuclear energy? Is it nuclear weapons, known for massive destruction, or anything else? Now let's go back to Burkina Faso. Is the captain planning to introduce nuclear weapons in Africa, a thing which the West is totally against? But, we know, he can't do such a thing. Maybe that shouldn't have been a thing to focus on, in a country which needs proper improvement. Recently, at the beginning of June 2024, Burkina Faso signed fresh nuclear-focused memorandums of understanding with Russia. What have you heard? Nuclear-focused agreements? Yes, of course. Focusing on nuclear energy, these memorandums of understanding, MOUs, are to cover education and training, infrastructure development, and public opinion in the next stage of Burkina Faso and Russia's cooperation on peaceful uses of nuclear technology. What great news these are! As nuclear energy can be used in the manufacture of nuclear weapons, it can also be put to peaceful use. Signed by Rosatom Director General Alexei Likachev and Burkina Faso's Minister of Energy, Mines and Quarries, Yakuba Zabre Guba, on the sidelines of the St. Petersburg International Economic Forum, a framework for interaction covering education and training in the field of nuclear energy, the assessment and development of nuclear infrastructure, and also cooperation concerning the forming of positive public opinion on nuclear energy was the main focus of these agreements. Adding to the already agreements signed in October 2023 and in March 2024, which declare a guidelines for the development of cooperation between the two countries with the aim of implementing both nuclear energy projects and using nuclear technology for medicine and agriculture in Burkina Faso, there would be links between educational institutions, training of teachers, and student exchange programs, including public opinion, where there would be activities aimed at raising public awareness of the benefits of non-energy applications of nuclear technology in areas such as medicine and agriculture. Thanks for being with us till now. Don't forget to thank the channel with any donations you are willing to offer for the better progress. Thanks. Now let's continue with the topic. When we go back to 2023, Burkina Faso's government signed an agreement with Russia for the construction of a nuclear power plant to cover the energy needs of the population. You should know that less than a quarter of the population of Burkina Faso has access to electricity. Energy in Burkina Faso is obtained primarily from diesel and heavy fuel, with some access to hydropower and solar. Hence, the use of nuclear energy as among the major sources of electricity is a better option and a great step taken by Captain Ibrahim Traore. Burkina Faso is one of the least electrified countries worldwide, currently at 19% overall, with 60% of the urban and only 3% of the rural population connected to electricity. Access to non-solid fuels is also very limited, reaching around 8% nationally. The captain knows that diversification of electricity generation is crucial in a country which is in dire need of transformation. This is why we always say that Africa needs leaders like Captain Ibrahim Traore, who stand tall towards seeing continued growth and development of their countries. If all go as planned, nothing will limit Burkina Faso in its economic growth, plus becoming a major economic hub in West Africa. If you thought that Captain Ibrahim Traore and Vladimir Putin had intentions of introducing nuclear weapons in Africa, it isn't like that. Why would the captain focus on nuclear weapons when people of Burkina Faso lack a number of basic and very important things, for this case electricity? Indeed, it can become problematic if the energy isn't used the way he intends it to be used in Burkina Faso. Using nuclear energy as a source of electricity is becoming a new way of electricity generation in Africa. So, the captain and Burkina Faso don't want to be left out from this wave. It should be known that nuclear energy protects air quality by producing massive amounts of carbon-free electricity. But did you know nuclear does more than just produce massive amounts of clean energy? When these agreements are realized, the nuclear energy will be used in a variety of applications, ranging from cancer treatments to fighting crime through radioisotopes. In agriculture, farmers will be able to use radioisotopes to control insects that destroy crops as an alternative to chemical pesticides. Captain Ibrahim Traore is increasingly showing the true signs of a good leader, who found a country lagging behind economically and politically to a one on a journey of becoming strategic economically and politically. Let's continue to wish good for him and Burkina Faso. President Ibrahim Traore has so far done a number of things, which are setting examples for other African leaders who think obtaining leadership is a chance to mismanage funds, putting it in their pockets while the citizens are suffering. What do you think about this move by the captain? Let's know in the comments, or you can just leave a like. As I earlier said, thanking the channel through any financial support is welcomed. The thanks tab on your app down the video is for your donations to the channel. We will be glad for your support.